You know, we've done some big fights in the past, many of the big fights in the past, and this is comparable to like some of my fights when, you know, I fought Chavez or all these big names. The press credentials we had to turn away were like tons of them. I mean, it's comparable to just all the major fights, and the great indication was obviously the sellouts of the arena, the opening up six more properties in Las Vegas for the closed circuit TV. So it's gonna be a great event. He's training hard. He's in great shape. He looks fast. He looks strong. He's already on weight. It's gonna be a very brutal. It's gonna be tough for both guys. It's gonna be a hard fight, but a fun one to watch. You know what? I see him happier. Happier. He's training with all this energy. He's looking incredible. I mean, he's fast. He's strong. He's built like a freaking tank, and he's really fast. So and smart. He's moving his head. He's side to side. He's and he's smiling a lot more. So and that's because of the weight. He doesn't have to drain himself anymore. So you know, those few pounds are gonna make a huge difference with his power and with his speed. For an ESPN card, we're gonna have the MGM filled up. I mean, it's amazing. But the card is great with Abraham fighting there, with Gamboa fighting as well. I mean, it's a great card from top to bottom as well. So I just want people to enjoy themselves, watch some great fights, and leave Las Vegas with a smile on your face. Lucas Matiz needed a break after his loss. And it was well deserved. He was off for a year, I believe. You know, regrouping. He was with his family. He's happier. He's fresh, and now he's back, and better than ever, and stronger than ever. So it's going to be very interesting to see how this fight pans out. But we have all the confidence in the world that Lucas Matiz is back, stronger and faster and better than ever. Wasn't the first option because obviously it's like two of our prospects and they're undefeated, but look, I tell my guys, my matchmakers, I tell them, look, you have to make good fights, and if it means putting our prospects against our prospects, then we must do it. You know, it's sink or swim here. If you either want to make it, want to become world champion, you have to fight the tough fights. You know, I mean, everything accordingly. There's protocol and everything. There's a plan. But if you want to be world champion, you have to walk through fire, and that's exactly what JoJo and Tino are gonna do. They're gonna walk through fire to get to that championship level. So it's from top to bottom. We're very happy of what we put together. Yeah, no, we all collaborated and we discussed it, and we were thinking of the undercard, and David Lemieux was a perfect fit, and to keep him busy, to expose him in such a incredible card like this one, where you're going to have millions of eyeballs watching. It was very important to get him back on there and keep him active. And so when we called him, he loved the idea, and here we are. I mean, we put together one of the best undercards in recent years.